Today we are exploring Boston's famous Freedom Trail. This historic New England city is the home of some of the most famous sites in American history, and luckily for you, they are all within a compact area nestled within Boston's old city. Join me on an incredible adventure as we explore every site along the famous trail and learn why this trail is so important to the American story. Hey everyone, JP here, and today we are in beautiful Boston, Massachusetts. So what we are doing here today is we are going along the famous Freedom Trail. So what this trail is, it's basically a marked trail that goes through the center and heart of Boston, and throughout it are amazing sites that were pivotal in the American Revolution. So we're gonna go through every site and we're gonna learn a little bit about each site and, you know, its significance to American freedom and the Revolutionary War. So the first site is here. This is Boston Common. This is the country's oldest public park. So you start here and you follow the trail. You go through Boston's downtown and some of the most historic areas of Boston, ultimately ending up at Bunker Hill, right? And I'm gonna explain to you guys what all of these things are. So without further ado, let's begin. The first site on the Freedom Trail is Boston Common. This historic and famous city park was established in 1634 and takes the claim as the oldest city park in the United States. The famous park is used by everyday Bostonians today as a place of recreation, but the park holds a fascinating history. This space has witnessed several pivotal moments in history, including colonial gatherings to protest British rule, as well as contemporary events. The park originated as a cow pasture, farmland, and even a cemetery until the colonial city encroached the area and it was established as a public city park. Make sure you check out the several public art pieces and monuments in Boston Common, and especially this one dedicated to the Boston Massacre, a site that we will see later on. So we are now at the second stop on the Freedom Trail. This is the Massachusetts State House. You can see this beautiful gold dome here. So it really represents Boston, and it serves as the basically the main house of government here in Boston. Now, an interesting fact about it is that the original parcel is on John Hancock's cow pasture. So this was John Hancock's land. The initial building of the Massachusetts State House started in about 1795. So you can go in and get tours if you're here Monday through Friday. We're here on a Saturday, so unfortunately we cannot go in the State House. But if you're interested in seeing some amazing architecture and some really beautiful pieces of just legislative government architecture, I'd really take a look at it. This iconic building serves as a symbol of the state's history and governance. It was designed by architect Charles Bulfinch in 1798 and is best known for its distinctive and beautiful golden dome. The next stop is Park Street Church. This iconic church, built in 1809, played a pivotal role in the abolitionist movement and has gained a reputation as a symbol of social justice and advocacy in Boston. Unfortunately, there was a wedding the day we were here, so he couldn't go in. Right next to Park Street Church is Granary Burying Ground. This historic graveyard is one of the oldest in the United States, dating back to 1660. This cemetery serves as the final resting place for many notable figures, including several signers of the Declaration of Independence and several prominent figures of the Revolutionary era, such as Samuel Adams, John Hancock, Paul Revere, James Otis, and many more. Things to know about Granary Burial Ground. So as you notice, there's a lot of famous people here, right? Now, these tombs, some of them are from the 1600s up until the 1700s, right? So a lot of them are actually faded and you can't see who lies here anymore. But if you have a family ancestry that has been in America for a very long time, so like pre-Civil War, 1700s, late 1700s, right? You may actually have ancestors in this burial ground. So I know it sounds kind of crazy, but ancestry goes exponentially. So like you may have like a great grandma or uncle or aunt or something that's buried here. So if you're interested in that, check it out. King's Chapel is our next stop. The church is known for its graceful Georgian architecture and holds a significant place in American history as the beginning of Unitarianism in the United States. Its pulpit has hosted several famous speakers, including George Washington and several other influential revolutionary speakers. The church was built in 1688 and was interestingly opposed by many of the early Puritan, aka Pilgrim settlers, in Boston because it held close allegiance to the Anglican Church back in England and the Crown. Right next to the church is King's Chapel Burying Ground. This cemetery, established in 1630, is one of the country's oldest. Though not as many famous people are buried here as in Granary Burying Ground, it offers a look into the cultural and societal values of colonial America. John Winthrop and Mary Chilton are buried here, adding to the site's historical significance, making it a captivating place to explore for those interested in Boston's rich history. When you're exploring the Freedom Trail, the city actually makes it pretty easy to navigate because there's these red bricks that go along the normal concrete, right? So if you don't have a map is probably better because it does kind of have spots where it starts and stops and it gets between streets, but you can follow the red brick road and go along the Freedom Trail. So take a look at that. You know, if you're getting lost, just look down. The next stop on the Freedom Trail is the site of the first public school. This is the site where Benjamin Franklin was educated, as well as other founding fathers. I found the site to be rather underwhelming since it's just a simple plaza now, but there is a monument to see that celebrates this historic site. In the same square sits the Boston Old City Hall. This iconic and architecturally significant building was built in the mid-1860s and is worth a visit. The city's administrative functions were housed here for about 100 years until they were moved to a more modern building in 1969. The next stop is the Old Corner Bookstore. This historic building was built in 1718 and served as a famous bookstore for several decades until quite recently when Chipotle took over the building. All I have to say is, wow, Boston. How could you let such a historic building fall prey to such commercialism? And I'm sure the answer comes down to simple dollars and cents. Next, check out the Old South Meeting House. This historic structure was built in 1792 and was founded as a Puritan meeting house. Notably, this is the site where colonists convened in 1765 to protest the Stamp Act, a pivotal event that led up to the Boston Tea Party and eventually the American Revolution against Britain. Okay guys, so where we are now is one of the most important sites in American history. So we right now are in front of the Old State House, right? So this exact small little corner that we're standing on right now is one, the site of the Boston Massacre. So we are standing exactly where it happened. So, you know, big massacre that you heard about in school your whole life, this is where it happened. So it happened right here in front of the Old State House. And this balcony here that you see right here, this is the spot where the Declaration of Independence was first read. So this is the first time the Declaration of Independence was presented to the newly found America. So this is an iconic piece of American heritage, and it's very important, and arguably, I would say, one of the most important sites along the Freedom Trail. We're also gonna go inside the building, so let's head in. The Old State House, erected in 1713, is one of the oldest public buildings in the United States. This building was the center of political life in colonial Boston and served as the seat of the Massachusetts colonial government. Inside the building houses an attractive museum where you can learn more about the structure's historical significance, the Boston Massacre, and sit in the Central Assembly Room, the place where the Declaration of Independence was first decreed to the newly founded American public. Faneuil Hall was constructed in 1742 and historically served as a marketplace for merchants and traders. Today it is now a touristy shopping center. This historic hall, however, served a pivotal role in the American Revolution as it functioned as a gathering place for change. The hall earned the moniker of the Cradle of Liberty, as meetings here led to many protests against the Stamp Act and Sugar Act in the mid-1700s, ultimately leading to the American Revolution. Now, if you want a little pause in your history lesson, I recommend you stop right outside of Faneuil Hall. So if you go along Market Street, which is right next to Faneuil Hall, you're gonna find tons of restaurants, bars, tourists, locals alike, and it's just an excellent outdoor public space. It's great in the wintertime and the summertime. So, you know, it's bumping all times of year. We're here in the summer, so it's extra bumping. But as you can see, there's people everywhere. There's tons of street performers. There's tons of things to buy and things to see. It really is kind of a good break and a good stopping point in the whole Freedom Trail experience. So if you want to stop here, I recommend you stop here, get lunch, and it would be probably around the time where you would get lunch if you start early in the morning. So definitely check it out. The next spot you have to check out is Union Street and the surrounding lanes. This small area is one of my most favorite sections of Boston because of the quaint and narrow England-like streets that bring you to lively pubs and restaurants within some of the city's most historic buildings. Okay, we're now back to the history lesson. So where we are now is the Paul Revere House, right behind me. Now, this is the oldest house in Boston, and this is where Paul Revere lived with his family. And it is likely that this is the place where he departed from when he warned troops about the British coming to Lexington and Concord. So, you know, when they say the British are coming, right? That was from Paul Revere, and he left from this house. Now, we're gonna go in the house, and we're gonna see how a house this old is designed, right? So it's from the late 1600s. It's a very, very old home, one of the oldest homes in America. And what's interesting about it is as you continue on the Freedom Trail, right? So once you get around here, you're gonna notice that you're in a different neighborhood, right? You're in the North End. This is Boston's Little Italy. Now, at the time of Paul Revere, Italians weren't really here yet, so it wasn't like that when he was here. However, you're gonna notice around here you have fantastic Italian restaurants, and they're very authentic. It's really good pastry shops. We can't go all into the North End. We're gonna do a video on that as well. This is just the History and Freedom Trail tour, but definitely check that out and maybe have dinner, grab something to eat, or grab a pastry while you're here. So let's head in.
The Paul Revere House was built in about 1680 and is the oldest remaining structure in Boston. This was once the home of the famous American patriot, his wife, and several children. Exploring the house offers you a glimpse into colonial life and architecture and allows you to compare your home's design to a home that is over 300 years old. A couple of blocks away is the next stop, Old North Church. This historic church was built in 1723 and is famous as being the site where two lanterns were placed in April of 1775 to signal Paul Revere and other colonists that the British were coming, ultimately initiating Paul Revere's famous midnight ride to Lexington and Concord. The church is an excellent example of Georgian architecture and is one of the most famous Anglican churches in America. The late Queen Elizabeth even attended services at this church when visiting Boston several decades ago. About a block away from Old North Church sits Copp's Burying Ground. This cemetery occupies a large hill between row houses in the North End and offers fantastic views of the city around it and Boston Harbor. The cemetery dates back to 1659 and claims some of the oldest tombstones in the city. As you peruse the grounds, look at the tops of the tombstones. On some of them, you can actually see musket ball holes from nearby battles during the Revolutionary War.
Okay, your next stop on the Freedom Trail is the USS Constitution, which is behind me. Now, getting from the last stop to here is probably the most arduous part of the Freedom Trail. It's a good 17 to 20 minute walk, and you have to go over a bridge and along like an arterial street. So it's kind of probably the most annoying part of the Freedom Trail with the walk back. Now, what's so great about the USS Constitution? So this is the oldest commissioned warship in the world. Yes, in the world. So this ship dates back to 1797. And what does commission mean? Commission means still sailing. Now, the ship doesn't go out often, goes out about once a year on the 4th of July into Boston Harbor to maintain its commission status. So we're gonna go on board the ship and we're gonna learn a little bit about it and kind of see how they designed ships in the late 1700s. So let's head on.
The USS Constitution, also known as Old Ironsides, was launched in 1797 and offers you a look into late 18th century naval ship design. As you climb aboard her, you feel like you're on a real pirate ship. Her tall masts and grand plank floors feel almost surreal. When you head down below deck, you can feel how the sailors felt living on the ship for months at a time, and it really helps you to appreciate the courage of our American military. See where they slept, ate, and passed the time, guarding and defending early American waters. As you continue along the trail, you will pass through Boston's Charlestown neighborhood. This is one of my most favorite neighborhoods in the city because it has such amazing 18th and 19th century architecture stacked neatly along narrow, almost European-like blocks. Definitely take some time to explore the area if you have the time. Okay, the next stop on the Freedom Trail is the Monument of Bunker Hill, which is behind me, this large structure here. Now, it's over 200 feet tall, and what it commemorates is a battle that took place here in 1775, and interestingly, actually, the American forces lost, the British forces won. However, the British forces lost a ton of their army, and it was really a turning point for the morale of the American troops. And what's so cool about it is you can climb to the top of it and you get amazing views of Boston and the harbor. So we're gonna climb all the way up and I'm gonna show you the views and teach you a little bit more about this special hill and the battle that took place here. The Battle of Bunker Hill was a pivotal turning point in early America's fight for independence because it really raised the morale of the colonial army. It doesn't look like it now with all the people peacefully enjoying the day, but on June 17, 1775, this hill was the site of a bloody battle. This is the last stop on the Freedom Trail, and here you can climb the more than 200 steps to the top, giving your long journey through the Freedom Trail a symbolic and beautiful end overlooking Boston. Now, when you're done with your long journey exploring the Freedom Trail, I recommend you have dinner at Warren Tavern. This historic pub dates back to 1780 and is one of the oldest taverns in the United States. Famous figures such as Paul Revere, George Washington, and Ben Franklin have all enjoyed a drink or two in this place. The tavern retains much of its original character and really helps you feel connected to the Revolutionary War history while you enjoy some fine New England cuisine. I always get New England clam chowder and seafood while in Boston. Okay guys, that was Boston's Freedom Trail. I had an amazing time showing it. There is a lot. It could take all day, depending on how long you spend at each site. It is a fantastic piece of American heritage, and it's something that every American and visitors from other countries alike really have to see when they're here in New England and Boston. Listen guys, if you like this kind of content, make sure you subscribe if you haven't already. Like this video, share this video with your friends, and leave me your comment below. Let me know about anything that I may have missed or any suggestions for other travelers. Guys, I had a great time showing it. Until next time, take care. Bye.